Shepherd of our soul, Shepherd of our soul,
Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up.
Father, we thank you, we bless you, we worship you, we exalt you, we magnify you. Thank you for yet another day. Father, thank you for the privilege given us to see this day. It's not a power, it's not a right to God. We are only privileged to see this day. Father, many people who do whatever we are doing better than us to God, they are no more now. Father, they were visited by death and they were taken away, but you protected us to God that we may learn how to live for tomorrow, how to live for the next seconds, how to live for now, so that when you come, we will not be found wanting. Jesus, speak to us this hour in the language you understand. Talk to me and talk through me to your glory alone. May I not speak my word, but your word alone. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, I have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Our message this morning is titled, Learn to Accept Correction.
Amen.
Learn to accept correction. Brethren, the problem humanity have today, not only Christians in particular, and all humanity in general, is accepting correction. Many people, it's very difficult to accept correction. And for you not to be corrupted, for you not to be crushed to hell, you must learn to accept correction. I mean correction, godly correction. Correction that will make you to be what God wants to be. But it's a pity that children of God these days, they run for correction or they hate whoever that corrects them. They run from the word of God that will correct them and recreate them. The Bible told us in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 5 to 6, Thou shalt also consider thy heart, that as a man chasteneth his son, so the Lord God chasteneth thee. As a man that loves his son, chasteneth his own child, so the Lord God uses his word to chasten us. Therefore, thou shalt keep the commandment of the Lord, thy God, to walk in his ways and fear him. Take correction. Live by correction. So that you will not be corrupted and go to hell. So that you will not be destroyed on that day. As a father that loves his child, teaches his child of how to live, of how to do things. So the Lord is chasing us today. Today's father, they don't chase their son, children anymore. Parents don't even, most parents don't even care about their parents, children anymore. But thank God we serve a God who cares about us. Parents, now a child of 14 years old can bring a car home now and they'll be drinking and celebrating without asking that child, where do you get your car from? A child now, a girl of 16 years old, can go to abroad now, bring money home, and start building 5 flats in the house, and we'll be celebrating, knowing that that child is using her body to make money. And the parents will be rejoicing over the iniquity. Husband now, can see a wife give prostitution, bringing money home, not caring of how the money is coming. As far as there is food, as far as people in Africa are saying, yes, we are enjoying making money, we are building houses. But our God is not so. Our God wouldn't want you to kill yourself in sin to make him happy. Our God is not a God who wants you to go and make money by any dubious need to come and pay tithes or do whatever you do for him. No. We serve a God who chasing you out of sin. Every instruction from the Lord, instruction to take you away from destruction. The Bible told us in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 12. Proverbs 3, I start from verse 9 to 12. For whom the Lord loves, he approves, even as a father corrects the son in whom he delights. Even as a father, the father of those days in particular, all those disciplinarians those days, used to correct their children. The way the father will streamline the children to the way of righteousness. So the Lord chasing us that we might not be chased into hell on that day. Praise Master Jesus. So Proverbs 3:12. Now, Proverbs 15:10-11. Proverbs 15:10-11. Correction is grievous unto him that forsake the ways. The reason why when they correct you, you are angry is because you are out of the way. Because you are not close to hell. The wave of hell is already drawing you. That's why whenever you hear the word of God that will correct you, you get angry. Your heart is boiling as burning water. Because you are not close, you are about to die. Satan is about to pluck you off. That's why whenever the word that will correct is coming, you are saying they are judging you. Why are you judging me? Why? Because you are not close to hell. Why? Because your soul is already burning, waiting for you to die. Not Deuteronomy, I'm reading Proverbs 15 from verse 10. Correction is grievous. It's painful to him that forsake the way. And he that hated reproof shall die. He that hated correction. He that don't want to hear the word of God that will take him away from sin. You know you are doing prostitution. And they are preaching about prostitution. You are angry. It's because you are about to die. Sin is death. The Bible says when sin is finished, it brings forth death. You are about to die, my brother. You are about to die, my sister. That is why the devil is making you to be proud in your iniquity. He that hated correction shall die. Verse 11. Hell and destruction are before the Lord. How much more than the heart of children of men? Verse 12. A scorner loveth not. I come again. 12. A scorner loveth not one that reproved him. Never will we go unto the wise. A scorner, somebody who is mischievous. Sinners, they hate people who correct them. Hey, that man of God, don't even say it. Hey, I will not call such a man of God. I will not go there. Why? Because they are crafty. Because Satan is their master. Because they are already in hell. They will be going to a place where their sin will be revealed. The Bible says the light cometh to the world. But the people hate the light because they are evil. The reason why you don't want to take correction, the reason why you are hating that sister that won't tell you the truth is because you are evil. And if you get not taken, you will die in that evil and you will go to hell. And you want to love that sister again. You want that sister to come and correct you again, and the Bible, the Lord will tell you, it is over. Now there is life in you. Let her take correction, my sister. Now they still have life in you. You have breath. That breath can cease at any time. You can stop briefly at any time. And the state you will be when the breath is stopped. If you die in that sin that the Lord has used as your friend now to tell you, my sister, what you are doing now is wrong, bro. My brother, the life you are living now is not supposed to be so. And you are looking for a way to hurt him or her. A time is coming which shall fall into a pit of hell, not yet lake of fire now, into the appetizer only. You want that sister again to come and correct you, but she will not be there anymore. You need that message again. That message that is to correct you. That message will not be there again. You bid to preach the message to yourself in hell. But then it will be of no use. Praise Master Jesus. Now, the Lord is speaking to your eye in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, 31 to 32. Is a very popular scripture here on this mountain. For if we will judge ourselves now, for if we call ourselves, you know what you are doing is sinful. The wages of sin is that there's no other payment for sin. That sinful life you are living, there's no other destination for a sinner than hell. If you and I will sit down and let yourself know, what I'm doing now is wrong. What I'm doing to this my friend now is wrong, bro. What I'm doing to this my brother now is wrong, bro. Myself, and let me take correction now. He said, if we judge ourselves, we will not be judged again. But when we are judged, we are chasing of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the word. The word of the Lord comes to you to chase you out of hell. The word of the Lord always comes to you to chase you out of that sin. Take correction now. Run away from that sin now. Because there's no other destination for a sinner than hell. No matter little the sin might be, no matter little the pride might be, no matter little the marriage might be, no matter the thing you are doing might be, as far as a sin, there's no other destination for it. Sister, brother, there's no need of living when you know that you will end up in hell. Take it into your mind, lovely gather. There's no need of living on earth yet. Life on earth is not worth living when you know that you will end up here. Just die now and go there, because if you die tomorrow, if you live for 100 years, you still die. You will still enjoy that hell. So what is the reason of living? I always tell myself, I don't know about you. I have no reason to be living on earth. If I will end up in hell, the only joy I have in living is because I have hope of there. It's because I know by the grace of God, I have hope of there. Without the hope in heaven, there's no life living. There's no need living on earth. So what do we do? Let us learn to correct ourselves. Hebrews 12, from verse 4. Hebrews 12, it says, ye have not yet resisted unto blood, striving against sin. It's only preach that preach to you now, you are crying. Thou shalt not, only thou shalt not, now you are crying. A time is coming after rapture. They will use hammer to preach the message to you. They will use cutlass. Then the grace is gone. The Holy Ghost is gone. You will be able to preach to yourself in pain and distress. It is very free now. But I'm going to tell you now, forgive. Let's forgive. You are saying, no, I will not forgive. No, I am who I am. You are who you are. No problem. A time is coming, the music will change. I am no more who I am now. Now, you are no less resist unto blood, strive against sin. That's fine. And you have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you. As for unto children, My son, despise not that the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art the brook of hell. Don't hate me because I'm telling the truth. Don't try to kill me. Don't try to avoid me because of my truth. If you are avoiding, you are avoiding hell, you are avoiding heaven. If you avoid the truth, you are embracing hell. Why will you run from somebody that the Lord is using to correct you, to recreate you, to reform it, to reform you? Why will I hate you because you are telling the truth? It's because you are close to hell. It's only somebody that Satan has chained down that will see light and run into darkness. It's only somebody of his mind who will see light and run away and enter darkness. Such a person needs help. So you need help. The help you need is the word of God you're hearing now. Learn to receive correction. For whom the Lord loveth. Verse 5. And ye forgotten in the exhortation which speaketh unto you as children. My son, despise not the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked. Verse 6. For whom the Lord loveth, he chastened as scourgeth every son whom he receiveth. Verse 7. If you endure chastening, God deal with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the father chasteneth not? Leave him. Any person that say leave, that person is dead. Man of God, let's forget her. I beg you, please leave her. If you talk to her now, problem. You are finished. If people not are saying leave her, she don't please leave her, leave him, you are gone. Verse 8. Praise Mother Jesus.
Hallelujah.
But if ye be without chastening, whereof all are particular, then ye are bastard. But if ye be without chastening, whereof all are partakers, then ye are bastards and not sons. Sister, if you don't like to take correction, you're a bastard, though. If you don't want God to correct you with his word, you're a bastard. I'm not going to say it. You call yourself a bastard. If you hear the word of God that will take you from hell, you are angry. You are saying, God, I'm not your daughter, I'm a bastard. But thank God for Jesus Christ. We have no bastard on this mountain.
Amen.
But if you know you're a bastard, I don't know, you better run away from that level you are now and come back to God. Because all bastards will be found in hell. It's only the children of God who will make it to heaven on the last day. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Verse 9. Furthermore, we have had father of our flesh who corrected us, and we give them reverence. Shall we not much rather be in subjection unto the Father of spirit and life? For they verily for a few days chasing us after their own pleasure. But he for our profit, that we might be partaker of his holiness. Your father might pet you. Your father knows you are doing prostitution. You know what you are doing is wrong. Hey, my daughter, you know, it's well now. He will do for to make it so that you'll be bringing money home. You don't care how the money's coming. I'll spend them happy. I will not go to heaven for my parents. I don't know about you. I will not go to hell for my in-laws. I don't know about you. I will not go to hell for you. I don't know about you. But the Lord here is chasing you for my own good, for I to be holy. You know why? Because without holiness, no one shall see him. Verse 11. Now, no chastening for the present seemeth to be joyous, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward, it yielded the peaceable fruit of righteousness, unto which are exercised thereby. I always tell people, to live holy life is painful, but gainful. Learn to enjoy the pain in righteousness. That's why we need to always fetch water from the well of life. According to Isaiah chapter 13, chapter 12, verse 3. Learn to make your heart joyful all the time. No matter the pain in holiness, it's better. It's better to get the pain of correction than you are celebrated in iniquity. And on the last day, you forever regret. If I knew, I would have joined that group that time. If I knew, hey, I never knew that those men of God were telling me the truth. I used to hate them. Don't hate us because of truth. Don't run away because of truth. Yes. One day is coming, you forever look for me, you won't see me anymore. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 58. But thou shalt say unto them, this is a nation that obeyeth not the voice of the Lord, their God, nor receiveth correction. Truth is perished and is cut off from their mouth. This is the nation that obeyed not the word of the Lord. These are people, but yet they are saying, hey, we are going to heaven, going to heaven. When you hate God, these are nations who don't want to hear the truth, but they are singing, hallelujah, we are coming to heaven. Which heaven are you coming to? Everybody want to make heaven, but they don't want to obey the truth that heaven is bringing. Go to churches everywhere full. Others say, Lord, make heaven. Make heaven in iniquity. The nations are fighting the Lord. The churches are fighting him. The pastors are fighting him. But they want to go to meet him on the last day. It's a lie. And I need to announce to you, it's a lie. If they remain that way, they will all perish. Every nation that refuse to hear the true word of the Lord, they all shall perish. Jeremiah chapter 5, verse, I will start with this, 5, verse 3. O Lord, anoint thy eyes upon the truth. O Lord, anoint thy eyes upon the truth. Thou hast stricken them, but they have not grieved. The Lord is talking to Nigeria here. And the church is Nigeria. And he's talking to that church in Europe here too. He has stricken them, but they are not grieved. That has consumed them, but they have not refused, but they have refused to receive correction. They have made their faces harder than a rock. They have refused to return. They have refused to return. If you see them, they are like, their faith is so strong now. If you have come out with Bible, hey, you see their face. I see them on the street. When they see me now, and they see me coming, they start charging their face. Don't charge your face, my brother. Don't worry. We have spoke already. You don't need to screw your face for me. Don't worry. I will pass you. But if time is coming, that same manner that you hate from this is coming. Look for me to talk to you. I will not be there anymore. Hey, such man, don't bring it to our church. Mm-hmm. Upon all the Lord is doing for you people. To repent, you don't have to repent. See Nigeria now. Upon all their sin, upon all the kings, they are still preaching the same message they are preaching. They still remain in their sin. They are not saying, Father, please come and rescue us. No. They are getting more harder. Their heart is getting stony. Upon the message you are receiving on this mountain, your heart is not broken. You are even getting harder. I pity you. We shall fall to her. That heart will come. Under a second, you become humble in here. You can be whatever you be now. You can do whatever you like now. Get stronger. Become rock. Become whatever you want to be now. You are now the lion of the tribe of your family. No problem. Be whatever you want to be. As far as you are still in this body, you can become anything. But a time is coming. The wave of hell alone will humble you. The breeze alone will humble you. You better humble yourself now and take correction. I better humble myself now. If there's any way I need to discipline myself and humble myself, I better do it now. Yes, the time is coming. You will look for somebody who will correct you. There's nobody anymore. No one. The only voice you hear is depart. And if your sin is much, like all these Muslims, nobody tell them depart. They enter here by themselves. Those people that live for God for at least for some time, those will stand before the judgment throne. They'll say, depart. Some people don't hear that word depart. Like the Muslim, they don't know what's called depart. They will just die and go to hell straight. All these Hindus, they just go to hell, they just die and go to the street. It's people who hear the word of God and they don't do it. They will read their book for them and search what they do and say, okay. Depart. So what will make me to depart now? And make to depart. Let us tell the thing now, depart from me now. That saying, depart from me. Or else, you want me to depart from the presence of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord this morning. There are more to say, but the word is enough for the wise. Humble yourself before the Lord. Humble yourself before the word of the Lord. Pride is nothing. This body is nothing. If you die now, even though they throw this body there, that you make, it's making you start to feel big now. Even though throw that pass on top of the body, you don't know anymore. Man, no solution. And redemption from this worldwide. Let us humble ourselves. Let us take correct. If food is our children, God is used to correct us, let us take it. Else, it will be too hot for us. May the Lord help me, help you, and help every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Are you out there? You're not born again. I beg you, come out now and accept Jesus Christ today. And I say this word after me. Dear Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. I'm coming out of pride today to embrace you. Satan, you have deceived me for so long, telling me I know who I am, whereas I never knew who I am. But today, I knew who I really was, that I was on my way to hell. Jesus, have mercy upon me. Father, forgive my sin. Today, I renounce the devil and all that concern him. I renounce pride. I renounce hell. And I accept you, Lord Jesus Christ, as my Lord and personal Savior. Take my name over the book of death and write it in the book of life. I receive power today to take correction. I receive power to take advice, godly advice. Because I am not born again, all things are passing away. And all things have become new. Thank you, Father, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, I pray with this one, so God. Father, it's painful, but it's gainful. Father, at what time that painful truth will come their way, anytime, give them the grace, so God, to receive it in joy. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Time is spent now. I don't know the prayer person to pray now. I want you to say, Father, you have spoken to me. That mind wants me to say I am this, for me not to take correction. You want the Lord to tell me that they depart from me. Today, you that mind, depart from me now. Pride, depart from me now. Sin, depart from me now. Open your mouth and pray. Pray for grace to take correction. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's pray one more prayer. Say, Father, on the last day, let no one be dropped out on this mountain. Jesus, on the last day, when we shall be counted in member of the mountain of solution and relationship in heaven, let no one be missing. In the name of Jesus Christ, let us pray.
Amen.
May the Lord help us in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.